My name is Michele Staton-Tindall, and I'm an associate professor in the UK College of Medicine, Department of Behavioral Science, and I'm also a faculty associate in the Center on Drug and Alcohol Research.
My research primarily focuses on drug use and high-risk behaviors in Appalachia. I'm from Appalachia. I'm from an area that used to look very different 15 or 20 years ago, an area where people felt safe, where people didn't lock doors at night, and those kinds of things. As an unfortunate consequence of the drug epidemic that now ravages that area of the country, people who didn't used to live in fear now live in fear. And drug use is really everywhere. It's hard to talk to anybody there who hasn't been impacted in some way. It's really close to my heart, and I really want to work to make a difference in that area. Probably the most exciting thing I'm working on right now is a study in Appalachia. We are recruiting women from three rural jails. We go into those jails, randomly select women, and do screening for substance use and high-risk behaviors. And over the course of about 2.5 years, we randomly selected and screened 688 women. 97% of them met the substance use criteria to enter our study. I knew it would be high, but I think all of us were really surprised at how high it actually was. Of the 400 who enrolled in our trial, 75% of them reported a lifetime history of drug injection. Not only were they just substance users, they were high-risk substance users. So as a follow-up to entering the study, doing a baseline interview, we also engage them in brief intervention before they leave the jail. The intervention allows us to focus on an individual and her high-risk behaviors. And then we follow them into the community 3, 6, and 12 months post-release from jail. And we've learned a lot. Almost 60% of our population test positive for hepatitis C. That's sort of where I see our work moving forward next in terms of increasing access to and utilization of treatment around hepatitis C. I've worked in prisons, I've worked in community supervision, probation, parole, I've worked in jails. The women that we come in contact with always have very unique vulnerabilities in terms of their health, their transmission of high-risk types of infectious diseases, HIV, hepatitis C, their mental health issues. In so many ways, those women are usually impacted by these issues as a result of relationships with high-risk people, high-risk partners, high-risk family members. And so I really want to focus my work in empowering women to make healthier choices and not just survive the addiction process, but to really thrive in a new and different kind of life. The criminal justice system serves as a wonderful venue for us to outreach and identify and intervene with women who wouldn't otherwise receive treatment or receive services. I love a good success story. I love getting letters in the mail from the women who said things to us like, nobody ever reached out to me before. I've been through all of these things, but I've never engaged in treatment. And you guys are the first ones to really encourage me to do that and to talk to me about some of the problems that I've had. I think one of the best things for me is to be affiliated with the Center on Drug and Alcohol Research here at UK. It's a multidisciplinary unit focused on the problem of substance use and the problem from all different angles. I would say if you're a young substance use investigator out there somewhere looking for a place to be, Kentucky's gonna rise to the top of that list. Some of the best researchers in the country, in the world, are here at UK.